Pag narinig mong salitang facelift, ito bang nai-imagine mo? Pwes, panoorin mo ito! Hi guys! For those who are new here, this is Surge On, and in here, we talk about everything surgical. So lahat ng sakit na kailangan ng opera. So this is another Maritas file, dahil hindi na ubusan ang sakit ang mga paborito niyong celebrities. So this week, break muna tayo sa cancer at pag-uusapin natin ang tungkol sa pagpapaganda. So facelift, a rare topic in the Philippine setting, dahil tabu pa rin sa Pilipinas ang pagpaparitoke. Good thing Miss Donita Rose is open to her facelift journey. Pero bago yan, patients first!
Si Donita Rose ay isang 49-year-old film actress host na tinaguri ang girl next door at ultimate crush ng mga uncles noon. Sumikat siya bilang Singapore-based VJ sa MTV Asia for many years, hanggang sa maglaylo siya para mag-focus sa pamilya. Her first marriage eventually failed pero nakahanap ulit siya ng pag-ibig sa isang pastor. Ngayon ay focus si Donita sa kanyang buhay, pamilya at pagiging may bahay, while regaining her confidence and self-esteem back.
At dahil glow up is real ang beauty goals ni Miss Donita this year, ibinahagi niya ang kanyang pagpapa-facelift courtesy of Optimum Medical Group. So let's find out kung ano-ano mga procedures ang ginawa kay Miss Donita.
You know when somebody greets you and says, "Wow, ganda-ganda mo," and you say, "Well, I woke up like this." I actually did wake up like this, but not because I'm naturally born like this, but it's because I did a facelift. So now we're going to be talking in this episode about beauty enhancements, cosmetic procedures that will help make you feel better about yourself as you get older.
So first thing you notice with Donita is plump ang mukha niya, which makes her appear younger. So no deep set eyes, no hollow temples, less prominent nasal labial folds, plump lips, walang bahid na galing facelift. So alam niyo ba kung saan tinatahi yung facelift? Malalaman niyo mamaya.
So I'm gonna introduce you to the team that made me look like this. Let me introduce first my sister-in-law, Dr. Cheryl Palad. Ate Doc, can you do the honors of introducing our lead doctor here?
With me is Dr. Rio Tika.
What we did to Donita is facelift, dual plane temporal lip, neck lip using Renovion, part graft, upper blep and our lower blep.
So iisa-isahin natin yan.
Facelift. Dual plane temporal lift. When you lift the temporal aspect of the face aside para mas bright ang eyes mo, because when you get older, nagsasagang corners ng mata. Neck lift to reduce the appearance of folds. So usually, sinasabay siya sa facelift para isahan ang tahi. Pangit naman kung banat na banat yung mukha mo and then kulubot yung leeg. Fat graft, when you take fat from other parts of the body at tini-inject sa mukha para mas maging plump kasi nawawalang taba sa mukha pag tumatanda ka. Blepharoplasty, upper and lower. So blephar is eyelids. So hihiwain ng excess skin para ma-open yung mata for the upper and to remove the eye bags for the lower.
It was done under general anesthesia. The result now, comparing to the before, and now...
Ta-da!
So it took us... at least 8 hours, including recovery period.
Mm-hmm.
Then the post-operative was done well. Dressing, then hyperbaric.
Mm-hmm.
Yan, so general anesthesia, so tulog yung pasyente. Good for the patient dahil walang sakit na nararamdaman. Better for the surgeon para focus sa procedure. So hindi magalaw yung pasyente at hindi magayong mukha, which happens pag local anesthesia ang ginagamit. So tinan nyo yung mukha ni Miss Donita before the procedure. So maganda na talaga si Miss Donita, so no comment na tayo dyan. Sana all. So issue niya is she looks tired and aging. So ano yung mga signs ng aging? Meron siyang overall fat loss sa mukha, so nawawala ng volume. So ang titinan mo dyan is ang area under the eyes. Ang tawag dyan is ang teardrops or daanan ng luha. So sometimes, akala natin malaki yung eye bags natin, pero in reality, lubog lang talaga yung under eyes. Kaya mas nagiging malaki tinan yung eye bags. Pag na-fill mo yan ang area with fat graft, nawawala usually yung eye bags dyan. So isa pang area na ito, ang temples mo. So lumulubog din yan. Also, prominent yung nasal labial folds. At numinipis na lips. Those are the areas na titingnan mo. Also, an even skin tone and wrinkles sa face and sa neck. So this signifies sun exposure, which increases as we age. So receding hairline also signifies aging, both in males and in females. Pansin nyo, asymmetric yung face niya, so that's normal. So that's what makes us beautiful. So our small imperfections make our face more interesting. And let's be honest, Donita is Donita. Kahit wala siguro siyang ngipin, maganda pa rin siya.
The recovery is good, past healing, and the scar is not visible.
No.
I like the result.
Yan, so not visible kasi ang scars mo dyan tinatago ng natural folds ng face mo. So you can still actually see the upper bleb incision, which is nasa fold ng upper eyelid. Ang lower bleb incision mo dyan follows sa contour of the lower eyelid. Pwede rin itago sa ilalim ng conjunctiva sa loob. So ang facelift and temporal lift incisions mo, tinatago yan sa hairline at sa folds ang tenga mo sa harap. So matatabunan yan ang buhok. Ang lipo at fat graft mo, tinutusok yan sa mukha gamit ang small probes at hindi halata ang mga scars over time.
What is Rinobion?
It uses helium energy to contract the muscles to cater to skin laxity. So we're right now, what we're doing is we're discussing the Rinuvian part where I did lipo on under my chin, so yes. There's an incision underneath.
Yes.
And then the Rinuvian is where the helium comes in and then it like tightened the skin.
Yes.
It looked like I had a burn on my neck, but I honestly did not see any swelling. In 7 days, it was absolutely gone.
Yeah, so Rinuvion. Rinuvion is a brand. So it is used after liposuction. So lipo ka muna to remove double chin. Isa pa pala sa signs ng aging is sagging skin. Ang excess skin mo sa chin causes the face to sag. Sabi nga nila, ang kalaban mo talaga habang tumatanda is gravity. Kasi habang tumatanda ka, hinihila ka talaga pababa. Lipo creates a more forwardly projected face because an attractive face is palabas. Na-mention ko yan sa chin implant video ko sa TikTok. So follow me on TikTok guys. So after ng lipo mo, gagawin ang Rinuvion. Yan, that is Rinuvion. So basahin natin ang sabi ng website nila. Rinuvion is the only device that is FDA cleared for contracting subcutaneous soft tissue. So i-insert siya sa ilalim ng balat. Siguro sa same incisions kung saan itinusok yung probe for liposuction. So it contracts collagen fibers and pulls the skin closer to the muscles for a more contoured appearance. So research-based daw, so most likely totoo. Unlike collagen-containing creams that promise to remove wrinkles, so hindi yan totoo guys. Malaki ang collagen molecules mo at hindi nito napipenetrate ang balat mo. So no, collagen creams don't work. So let's examine this picture. So see that? Most likely, that is the insertion point on the liposuction probe. Medyo may pasapa siya, magkabilang sides yan. Kita nyo yan? That is the incision site for the facelift sa harap ng tenga. Kung hindi magandang yung pagkatahi, may iba na nagpepeklat ang area na yan. So alam mo na nagpa-facelift. Kung magaling ang surgeon at pulido yung tahi, walang bakas kang makikita. So that is the insertion for the temporal brow lift. To open the eyes at magmukhang fresh. At hindi inaantok yung pasyente. So staplers yung ginamit, so pwedeng magkapeklat. Pero no issue siya kasi natatabunan naman siya ng buhok. So that is the upper bleb, gaya ng sabi natin. Overall, magapa talaga yung mukha niya kasi bago pa lang. Yung nakikita nyo sa TikTok na drastic changes, magapa po yun. That is definitely not the final result. Siyempre, nasugatan yan. Expected na yan na magkakapasa at mamamaga. So mawawala din yan over time. So everybody heals over time. Since mention na natin ang TikTok facelift, nakita nyo na siguro ang babaeng ito. Yan, that is a hemostatic net. So tinatanggal din yan at magiging okay din yung pasyente over time. May YouTube short din ako nyan sa baba, so hanapin nyo na lang. So wala ka talagang dapat katakutan sa facelift. Just make sure that you have a great team that is capable and licensed to do facelift.
So, I know that there are different types of facelifts, right? There's like a full-on facelift, a deep, I think I heard you mention deep plane facelift. In the States, they have mini ponytail facelifts, mini facelifts. What is the difference between each of these facelifts?
Yeah, what was done to Donita is a more of a imbricating procedure. So this is more conservative rather than the deep plane.
So let's break it down. So Donita's main procedure is a facelift. Maraming uri ng facelift. So we'll only mention those na nabanggit ni Donita. Kasi ito yung mga common na ginagawa. So full, deep plane, mini facelift, ponytail facelift, and smas. So first, let us differentiate according to depth. So pwedeng deep plane or smas. Smas is superficial musculoaponeurotic system. Ito ay muscle layers sa ilalim ng balat. Ang aponeurosis guys, fibrous tissue yan. So nagdedicate ng flat muscles mo sa katawan to its attachments. Kung long muscles, tendon. Kung flat muscles, aponeurosis. So marami kang aponeurosis sa katawan. Meron sa hita, meron sa bungo, etc. Basically, anywhere na kailangan na may flat muscles. Sa case na mukha, sa mga muscles of facial expression mo, meron dyan. Smas ang tawag dyan. So superficial meaning mababaw. Hindi siya malalim. Dahil nasa ilalim lang yan ang balat. So tingnan niyo ang picture nito. So nasa ibabaw lang siya. Ang ligaments mo, nasa ilalim yan. Pag ang facelift mo umabot dyan, deep plane facelift ang tawag dyan. So doc, bakit may smas at may deep plane? So in older patients na gusto magpa-facelift, ang kailangan mo dyan hilahin pataas is ang mga ligaments mo sa baba. So hindi na kaya ng smas lang yan. So kung masyadong kulubot at nagsasag, more drastic approach. In cases na mas bata pa, mga 30s, mga 40s, gaya ni Miss Jolene, ay Miss Donita. Nagaya ni Miss Donita, pwedeng ang smas layer lang ang hilahin mo and no need to go deeper. So depende yan sa assessment ng doktor mo. So ano naman ang full, mini, and ponytail? So depende yan kung saang part ng mukha ang sagging. Mini facelift pag ang jaw lang at lower cheek mo ang sagging. Pero pag sagging na ang upper cheek mo ang temporal area, pwede kang mag-extend dyan for a full facelift. Ponytail facelift is a brand. So instead of iwan na makikita sa harap ng tenga, ang incision ng ponytail facelift mo is makikita sa ilalim ng buhok sa temporal area dito on both sides. So that kahit naka-ponytail ka, walang bakas na nagpa-facelift ka. So meron ding endoscopic approach na walang malaking hiwa. Limitation ng last two is usually upper part lang na mukha ang nababanat. So hindi masyado sa jaw area. Anong mas magandang facelift, Doc? So depende yan sa area kung saan nagsasaging. Kung bata pa, pwede ponytail lang muna. Pag older na, better na mini or full na talaga. So walang one size fits all. So na-mention din ni Doc ang imbricating. So dalawa yan, imbricating versus plicating. Plicating, pag fold lang, then tahi para mabinat. Pag tinanggal mo ang excess mass at tinahi, imbricating na ang tawag dyan. Mas matibang imbricating kaysa sa plicating's mass.
The plane is you go under this mass. Because layer. It's mass a layer deeper than this mass.
Okay.
So this one is an imbricating procedure. It's more conservative. The sadness is mild to moderate.
Yes.
So what is important, which is dramatic in your part, is the stem cell rich fat grafting.
So stem cell rich fat graft. So think of your face as a grape. Pag kulang sa fat due to aging, nagiging kulubot. Parang resin. So kailangan mo injikan ng taba from other parts of your body para bumalik yung volume. Kasi kung facelift lang yan, liliit ang mukha mo dyan. Yan ang reason why may iba na hindi nila kamukha yung sarili nila after facelift. A good facelift result is someone who is a younger version of you, not someone who doesn't look like you.
It was done through an additive. Uh-huh. We use stem cell plus PRP.
Okay.
You get it from your blood, process it, you get the growth factor, mix it with the fat, and the result is fantastic.
Yes. So they took the fat from my thigh. I got a free thigh liposuction. Yes. And then you took the fat and then you centrifuged it, I guess.
Yes.
And then it was put here.
So PRP is platelet rich plasma. So kung nagpapaderma kayo, familiar kayo dyan. Actually, even fat graft alone is rich in growth factor. So aside from creating volume, nawawala din ng blemishes, discolorations, and wrinkles. You don't get that with synthetic fillers. And since it's from you, walang rejection and granuloma formation.
I would say that was kind of like the dramatic part for me of the procedure because you have to overfill it first so it kind of puffs up because it only retains about 70% of the fat, right? Is that correct,
okay.
Dr. Baker?
So, we're gonna bridge with what Dr. Nicole said about the 6 to 9 month downtime period. This is the back and forth. Yeah. It's very important between the patient and the surgeons. It takes a lot of wound healing. Mm. That's why you have to go through the hyperbaric to improve and hasten the healing process.
May dalawang school of thought for fat graft. Kung may iba kagaya ng ginawa kay Donita, overfill ka dahil hindi lahat na-absorb. May iba din na normal feel and observe. At kung may hindi kumapit na fat, pwede kang magdagdag ng fat on follow-up check-ups. Since sa chan mo sa hita mo yan galing, stubborn fat yan, so hindi madaling mawala. Notice that pag nagda-diet ka, unang nawawala dyan is ang fat sa mukha mo kaysa sa bilbil mo. So pag nagpa-fat graft ka, that fat stays forever pag inabsorb. So pumayat ka man or hindi, plump pa rin ang mukha mo. So hindi siya synthetic fat na kailangan mo ulit-ulitin every few months. Mas mahal siya, yes, pero mas permanent. You also don't get that uncanny valley face, yung alam mong may filler sa mukha.
You mentioned the hyperbaric chamber. The healing process was so fast for me. After 7 days, I just looked a little swollen. Mostly this part because of the fat that was grafted there and it was puffy. And then the tightening of this part and this part, which was swollen. Well, the drains looked a bit weird. So I looked like an avatar in the beginning, as I mentioned.
It was necessary.
Yeah.
Drains are there to prevent hematoma, para hindi magkulang blood sa loob, para mas dumikit ang balat mo sa underlying tissues, so mas mabilis ang healing process. So that is also the purpose of hemostatic nets na nakikita natin sa mga TikTok videos from Thailand. So hindi magpepeklat yan, especially if earlier tatanggalin yung tahi. The earliest time na kumapit yung balat mo, tanggal agad para hindi na mag-react ang balat mo and form scar tissues.
Before I went under the knife, you mentioned about possibly doing implants, which you did not do because I think my forehead is a 5 head.
Ha! Yeah.
It's the reason we postponed doing...
It's supposed to be implants here was supposed to lift it, but because my forehead is too big...
It might be bigger, it might show bigger.
The endotype will show.
Yes.
Emboss.
So it will be seen.
Yes.
Facial implants can be applied to the face kung ayaw mo ng fat graft. So mas predictable ang outcome kasi pwede mo i-personalize ang size at ang shape ng implant. Kung ayaw mo rin ng mga more invasive procedures na kailangan biyakin yung buto, pwede ka magpa-implants na lang. So pwede siya sa chin, pwede sa cheeks, sa panga, or sa forehead. Hindi siya mabigat. More common din siyang ginagamit sa mga trans undergoing facial feminization surgery. Males kasi have flat foreheads and prominent brows. Para magbukhang babae, binabawasan ang forehead at naglalagay ng implants para maging rounded ang noo.
Si ate, we've been talking about doing this for a while now since I had lost 40 pounds. My face started to sag. My face looked different and it was the first time that I noticed my aging. And then the four of you came together and you've been looking, you've tears of mine to say, how can we make sure that she goes back to looking 23 again, but naturally, right?
Like what I said, the goal should be to look like a younger version of you, not look like a different person.
You can see the blemishes,
yeah,
the wrinkling and blemishes. What we did here is a derma roller. Yes,
yeah, okay.
We did a derm roller with a PRP and growth factors at the same time stem cell.
Okay,
so the improvement is dramatic here.
So ang principle ng derma roller and microneedling as a whole is that you make microtrauma sa balat. So ang balat mo magpaproduce ng collagen at elastin for healing. Over time, magiging less visible ang wrinkles at blemishes mo. So, careful lang kasi unlicensed, unsterile at maling paggamit ng derma roller, especially yung nabibili online, can actually cause scarring.
You also did some fat grafting to my lips,
yes.
And
tell me, so fat augmentation.
Yes.
At the lips.
It is seen here, look.
Yeah.
That is the beauty of
fat. That is the beauty of fat. There is a great improvement, the volume and the glow.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, because of the fat.
Well, I definitely have the glow.
So I made a video about lip lift, which I will link down below, how it contributes to looking youthful. Pag nag-inject ka dyan ng lip filler, liliit ang measurement ng filter mo, making you look younger. Huwag lang sobra at magkakaroon ka ng shadowing, or magmumukhang may bigote ka pag nasinaga ng araw.
And of course, you know, you still have to go through the recovery time, but it's so exciting every day to see the improvements, the drastic improvements that take place. And I really cannot thank you guys enough for working so hard and tirelessly to make sure that, you know, it's number one, it's done right, and that that I would be entirely happy with the results.
Yes, so kudos to the team. It looks natural and no uncanny body feels. Hindi siya overly done.
This is the reason why I'm doing this vlog, because if it was something I wasn't completely happy with, I wouldn't want others to experience that as well. There are people out there who are very skeptical, myself included. If it wasn't for my sister-in-law, no go. I would not do anything surgical on my face, just because I'm afraid that it won't turn out the same, or it might make me into a different person. And so there's so much stigma surrounding cosmetic surgery.
So stigma, most especially facelift. Kasi rito kayo ngayon sa Pilipinas, mas open na tayo. So ilong, chin, dibdib, liposuction. Pero facelift, hindi pa masyado. So marami actually nagpapa-facelift, pero walang umamin. So it's good that Tunita came clean with her procedure, para hindi na rin magtaka yung mga tao na bakit ang bata pa nila tingnan. Because basically, they had work done. So it frees people from the depression and the low self-esteem, knowing that pare-pareho lang tayong tumatanda. And you always have the option to do something about it or not.
But if they see the before and the after, and the fact that I am in the entertainment business, and that, you know, beauty doesn't come easy. Wow! It's stressful, yeah. Diba?
We just want to thank you
for
this great opportunity to improve
us.
And trusting us.
Yeah.
Our team, we are proud of you.
Yeah.
Yes, as Beyonce would say, pretty hurts. So you have to go through the swelling and the hematoma if you want to go from this, to this. So hindi siya overnight. So kailangan mo lang talaga magtiwala na mahuhupa din yung maga. Kaya dapat do intense research on the works of surgeons para you have the peace of mind that everything will turn out beautiful, especially during the long healing process.
Sabi ko, you know, surgery is not for everybody. Because mental health, you know, we need to make sure that you're in the right place. One of the reasons why I also did this was because, you know, I went through a lot of trauma before, and I went through a time of healing and spiritual healing, mental healing as well. But now it's more of like the physical healing. This is what it really feels like for me. I feel like I'm born again,
yes.
Not just spiritually, but physically. I am just so grateful to you guys, and I highly recommend them to everybody.
The rule of cosmetic surgery is this. Do it for yourself and not for anyone else. Not to be liked by others, not for revenge glow up, not during the height of your emotion, whether that be anger or happiness. Do it when you're ready, when you're calm and you're clear-headed, when you've decided and thought about it over and over again, and do it for your own life.
For your life.
If you feel like you're ready, go! Just be sure that legit cosmetic or plastic surgeon ang gagawa sa inyo and do research, research, research. Knowledge keeps you safe and frees you from the fear of what is about to happen. Always remember, your body is your temple and your face
sounds familiar!
So that's it for today's episode of Marites Files. See you again next week for another meaty surgical chisem. Till next time, search on guys!